Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by Hero. Hero's up in Washington State. He had a question from Pivot Table Data Crunching. There's an example in there and basically showed how to create a year-over-year summary report. I want to walk through the steps for that. We can do it with the pivot table, but you have to go through a couple of obscure tricks. So we have a data set here that has data from both 2006 and 2007. We're going to go to Data, Pivot Table, Finish, and basically put the date along the left-hand side and then maybe revenue in the heart of the pivot table. Now, we want to group those daily dates. Group those daily dates up to both years and months. So I'm going to go to the first daily date, right-click, and choose Group and Show Detail, and then group, and say that I want to group it up to both months and years. You never want to choose just months in this dialog box, because what it'll do is it'll take January of this year, January of last year, and put it together into a single row called January, which really never made any sense to me. So what we're going to do, now you'll see that what's interesting is where we initially had one field along the left-hand side, just the date field, we now have dates and years. And it's interesting that Excel does this, breaking things out into two different fields, because now we can take the year field and move it across the top. So that way we can see year versus year, what the revenue was. Now I'm going to take the grand total off. So we'll go to the pivot table, table options, and remove grand total for rows. So that way we have 2006, 2007. Now, the example in the book then went through and said, well, wouldn't it be interesting to show maybe a year-over-year comparison? So let me take the revenue there and add it a second time, move the data field, so that way it's a second column out here, and we can say, you know, show it as a percentage of the previous year or something like that. I click the field settings button. I'll say percentage growth. And then click the options tab. The options tab gives us a whole bunch of more settings. So we can say that we want to show it as a percentage of, in the years field, the previous item. So click OK. And now what we get over here is the 2007 is showing us the percentage growth from the previous year. Now if we'd had data in here for 2005, the calculation would work OK for 2006. But you basically get the idea of how you can take daily dates that span several years, group them up to months and years, and then move the years to be a column field and be able to show year over year growth. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.